Hi everyone, myself Bamsi. In this video, we are going to see how to install ELK Stack using Ansible Playbook. Ansible allows you to automate the creation, configuration, and management of machines instead of manually keeping servers updated, making configurations, moving files, etc. You can use Ansible to automate this for a group of servers from one control machine. We will set up Ansible master and slave nodes, and then we'll try to use Ansible master to install ELK stack on the node server. Let us get started with the implementation steps. First, let us create two servers and install Ansible and set up Ansible between both the servers. I am going to use Ubuntu machine, and let us take t2.xlarge. In configure instance details, mention number of instances as 2, review on launch, launch. Select the key pair which you already have with you, launch instances. Now we will connect to both the machines, and we will set up SSH connection between both of them, and we will install Ansible on the master server. Grab the IP addresses and use mobile extend to connect to both of these hosts. And let us start installing Ansible on the master machine. Go to the Ansible documentation and copy the steps and execute one after another. I am updating the system using sudo apt update, and then I am installing software properties common package, and then we can add the repository for Ansible, and we can install Ansible. Ansible is installed on the master machine. Next, we'll try to generate SSH key and copy that key into the node server. Use ssh-keygen command for generating the SSH key. Once the key is generated, go to that path which is present under /root/.ssh-id_rsa.pub. Copy this id_rsa.pub and paste it in the node server authorized_key section. Go to .ssh. And here you will have authorized_key file. If not, you create a new one. If vi authorized keys, append the key which you copied from the first machine. Okay, once you copy the key, close this file and test the SSH connection from the master server to this machine. Grab the IP of the second machine and just mention SSH and IP of the second machine using ifconfig command. You will get the IP. Copy the IP from the inet section and paste it in the first machine. Now say yes for this, and we are able to connect to the second machine. You can just do exit. Now there is SSH connection between both the hosts. Now we can add the host in /etc/ansible/host. This is Ansible inventory file. If you want, you can keep a name for the group and simply add the node, or else you can directly add the node. We are saying simply node and paste the node IP. Save this file and just check whether we are able to ping this host from Ansible or not. For that, use Ansible-m module ping all. We are able to ping the node. That means Ansible setup is perfect between both the machines. Now we'll go and get the Ansible playbook from my GitHub repository and add this node and start installing ELK stack using Ansible playbook. This is my GitHub repository. From here, go to Ansible repository, click on clone or download, copy the URL, and just say git clone that particular URL. We have cloned the repository. Just if you want to see the project structure, go to cd Ansible. This is the structure. Inside this, we have Ansible ELK playbook. In the Ansible ELK playbook, we have roles. In the role section, we have different roles. One role for Java, another role for Kibana, another role for Apache to Elasticsearch. We have different roles. And in each of these roles, we have main.yml file where we have mentioned how to install that. For suppose, let us take Elasticsearch one. I will show you one later. All you can go through all the files. In the Elasticsearch, we have tasks folder. In the task folder, we have main.yml where we have mentioned how to install Elasticsearch. If you see the modules, we have used ap_key module, apt module, apt_repository module, and apt modules and line in file modules. Different modules we have used. If you know the manual procedure, you will understand these modules very easily. For the manual procedure, you can refer my other videos where I have explained how to install ELK stack using manual steps. This is equivalent of manual procedure. Let us save the file and start running our Ansible playbook. Go back to your Ansible ELK playbook folder and just say Ansible-playbook and mention your inventory file. We are executing Ansible-playbook main.yml. In the main.yml, we are referring the roles whichever I have shown. The first, it is updating the apt package manager, and then it is installing Java. Now it started with Elasticsearch task. And all these tasks are from equivalent roles from the project structure which I showed in earlier. Now Elasticsearch is done and it is executing logstash. And in the meanwhile, we'll try to add the security groups for the port numbers in the node server. You can expose 9200 port, which is for Elasticsearch port number, and 5601 for Kibana. These are the ones which we want to access it from outside network. Save the rules. Now copy the server IP and try to see whether Elasticsearch is loading or not. This is not loading because Elasticsearch is just now restarting. Previously, it was not started. We are just restarting it. Once this task is done, once the Elasticsearch restart task is done, we can go back to UI and we can cross check. Elasticsearch is restarted and logs has given everything. We can go back to UI and we can see Elasticsearch is loaded, and we'll go to Kibana and grab the IP and just replace 9200 with 5601. Kibana UI is also loading. Once the Kibana UI will open, we need to still define the index pattern. We install metric bit for server performance monitoring. Explore your own data and go to the index patterns. We install metric bit for server performance monitoring. Enter metric bit hyphen star as the index pattern and select the timestamp field. In the index pattern, just enter metric bit hyphen this and select timestamp field as the time filter field name. Create index pattern. Now, if you go to the discover page, we will have all the server side parameters. Go to the discover page. Sorry, discover tab. Here you can see the performance metrics of server. Thanks everyone for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my video channel.